Welcome back to Let's Play Castlevania Circle of the Moon. In our last episode, we finished off the underground waterway and also beat Camilla in our first shot, I should say. Now, as you can see, I've done a lot more exploration off screen. I've actually almost finished mapping out the entire area, except for that big chunk up above in the center between the outer wall and the chapel. In fact, both of those two areas are areas altogether. First one, right up in the center, is the next area we're going to. The one right surrounded by the chapel on almost all sides is the battle arena. We're not ready for that. In fact, the battle arena is actually optional. I think I'm actually going to do that as an optional video. Oh, I forgot an upgrade, didn't I? In fact, I forgot too. I did that entire run through, and I forgot two upgrades. Not too shabby, if I only forgot two of them. I think I'll go back down here, and I will save again. Because beating Camilla actually is another trigger for more powerful enemies to get into the past areas. You'll see what I mean a little later. Now, I also tried to grind the, I think it was either the Pluto or the, which one is it? It's not Pluto. It must have been Uranus or something. I'm not going to make the obvious joke. You actually only cause the monster that holds those cards to appear after fighting death. And it only appears in the room where we fought the Iron Golem. There's another one that's a palette swap. It's a palette swap of it in the room where you fought Cerberus. But that one only appears after you fight Camilla. The third one of those only appears in the battle arena. Yeah, as you can see, these guys are now a lot more common. They sure were not here when we were here last time. And even though we can kill them in three strikes, they're still really, really annoying. Alright. Good so far. Also, you can see that I've also taken care of the rest of the warp points, except for the one in our next area. Getting that one up there near the battle arena is a giant pain. But, hey, you gotta make some sacrifices. Alright, as you can see, we now have wind demons here. Wind demons, say it again with me, are a giant pain in the ass to deal with. Precisely because of those frickin' loop-de-loops that they summon. Having the boomerang is a frickin' godsend. I'm nice. In fact, I don't think we're actually going to be de-equipping the boomerang anytime soon. Because, let's face it, our next area is full of lots of platforming and a ton of really tough enemies. Heal back up. As you can see, the forest armors have decided to migrate over here. Them and their extremely long-ranged attacks. Yeah, they will start migrating back here after you beat Camilla. Now, I also missed something up here. And also, we gotta take care of wind armors. Wind armors also have a fair amount of range to them. Oh, come on, where is that? I know I missed that up here. There we go. Oh. Dear Lord, no. Okay. Well, that was fun now, wasn't it? Do not knock me down. Alright, now that we've got ourselves our brand shiny new Rock's Feather, we've got a lot more exploration we can go and do, especially up here. I'm actually going to do some waiting so that I can recover all that hit points that the wind armor and that nightmare took off from me, because we are going to need it. The observation tower only has one save point. Yeah, you heard me right. It only has one save point. Right. Yeah. And on top of that, it has some of the toughest encounters in the game. Short only of Dracula. Celebrate the last area of the game than with the first song in the entire series. That is indeed Vampire Killer, the first level music from the first game. Oh boy, legions. These guys don't attack. They will curse you, though. As you can see right there. Do I have any uncurses? I better have uncurses. Good, I have a whole bunch of them, actually. really all they do. They just move toward you and curse you. Well, at least Legion's not a boss like he is in the last few games. You're gonna make me burn through all my curses. Oh shit, there's two of them. In this game. Oh boy, these are where the wind armors come in. Jump over you guys, because I really don't feel like it. Well, that's better. Let's see, what level are we? 38. Oof, we got a lot of grinding we gotta do. Lots of grinding indeed. We gotta be at least level 45 before we can fight the boss of this area. And thankfully, well, that works. All right, what's over here? Oh boy. Evil pillars, huh? Oh, minotaurs. right, it's bad enough that we got a Minotaur. We got two of them. We got a Minotaur and one of those evil pillars. At least it can't reach us up here. Also give us the golem card, which is all right, but hey, there are better ones out there. As well. I can literally just... This is amusing, but I guess it would take a while. Jeez, I'm already 20 minutes here and I'm barely through much of that. Thank you. basically a palette swap of a frigging. Gorgon! Oh, that's embarrassing now, isn't it? All right, once more with feeling. Don't get cocky this time. Okay, there's that part done. Thank you. out the wazoo. Wait here until we get our hit points back before we have to get back into the room with the legions and get cursed again. And see if we can make it through the room with the evil pillars and the sirens. Yay us. And also, try not to get cocky with the cat above us. Me back and knock me forward. I think I just blew through my meat. Yep, I did. That sucks. I was saving that for later. the alarm. There we go. There's our safe point. And on that note, I think we're going to leave things off right here. So I will see you guys in our next episode. Thanks for watching and stay safe.